thanksgiving and celebrate His law. Come to the table and there His presence. Feast with thanksgiving and celebrate His law. This is the house of the Lord, and the gates are open wide. Sinners and saints, strong and faint, all welcome to come inside. Come to the table, enter His presence. Feast with thanksgiving and celebrate His love. Come to the table, enter His presence. Feast with thanksgiving and celebrate His love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to Philemon. Beloved, I have experienced much joy and encouragement from your love, because the hearts of the holy ones have been refreshed by you, brother. Therefore, although I have the full right in Christ to order you to do what is proper, I rather urge you, out of love, being as I am, Paul, an old man, and now also a prisoner for Christ Jesus. I urge you on behalf of my child Onesimus, whose father I have become in my imprisonment, who was once useless to you, but is now useful to both you and me. I am sending him, that is my own heart, back to you. I should have liked to retain him for myself, so that he might serve me on your behalf in my imprisonment for the gospel, but I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that the good you do might not be forced, but voluntary. Perhaps this is why he was away from you for a while, that you might have him back forever, no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, a brother, beloved, especially to me, but even more so to you, as a man and in the Lord. So if you regard me as a partner, welcome him as you would me, And if he has done you any injustice or owes you anything, charge it to me. I, Paul, write this in my own hand. I will pay. May I not tell you that you owe me your very self? Yes, brother, may I profit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
The Lord secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
The fatherless and the widow he sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through all generations. Alleluia.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits for his word. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Asked by the Pharisees when the kingdom of God would come, Jesus said in reply, "The coming of the kingdom of God cannot be observed, and no one will announce, 'Look, here it is,' or 'There it is.' For behold, the kingdom of God is among you." Then he said to his disciples, "The days will come when you will long to see one of the days of the Son of Man, but you will not see it. There will be those who will say to you, 'Look, there he is,' or 'Look, here he is.' Do not go off. Do not run in pursuit. For just as lightning flashes and lights up the sky from one side to the other, so will the Son of Man be in his day. But first, he must suffer greatly and be rejected by this generation." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, today's Gospel reading may sound so familiar or may be common to all of us whenever we would near the end of a liturgical year, whenever we would approach December for the first Sunday of Advent, madalas makakarinig po tayo ng mga kwento tungkol sa papaano matatapos ang mundong ito, papaano ang paghuhukom, o papaano ang mga huling araw ng mundong ito. And as I've said, this Gospel reading is one good example. And we will be hearing a lot of these most especially come next week. But you know, my dear brothers and sisters, while it is important to look forward, it is also good to prepare by living the present moment. Jesus reminded his disciples with these words, "The kingdom of God cannot be observed by saying that here it is, here he is, there it is, there he is, for the kingdom of God is among you, it is among us." Our catechism would say that it is the already, but not yet. Pero nariyan na, buhay na, kasama at parte na ng ating buhay, hindi malayo sa atin, ginagawa at binubuhay na natin ito araw-araw. It is a big temptation to always look forward that we do not anymore tend to live in the present moment and not to live anymore what is within us and what is of us. While it is good once again to prepare by looking forward, it is much better to live rightly our today. Living the present so well and good is just confirming what Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is among you." If you are a lolo or a lola, then be a good lola or lolo today and in the next days. If you are studying, do it well and study well. If you work, work today so well. If you are a mother or a father, be a good parent today and in the next days. As a Catholic, we express and embrace our faith every day. As a person, we do what is entrusted to us, good, big or small, doing everything well today. It is good to look forward, but let us not forget to live happily the present moment. Baka sobra naman pong tanaw tayo sa susunod at sa mga haharapin natin na hindi na natin nagagawa ang tama ang mga ngayon sa buhay natin. We do what God has blessed us today, big or small, so that we can embrace His kingdom, this kingdom that is His presence in our lives.
Please stand.
Let us pray with the fullest trust to the Lord of life, who waits for us at the end of life, at the end of life's road. Let us say, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may constantly prepare the people to welcome Christ when He returns, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That by their commitment to justice and peace, Christians may bring all people together in faith and hope and prepare them for the final coming of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The tragedies caused by nature or human cruelty may not destruct us or weaken our faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may accept Jesus in their hearts and see Him present in their trials. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that those who have died may be freed from the troubles of this world and enjoy everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass as we pray for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you are always near to us. You know our needs better than we do. Help us to be always aware of your presence, now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Teodoro, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Yesterday, the Archdiocese of Manila mourns the passing away of our Auxiliary Bishop Emeritus, His Excellency Teodoro J. Buhain, D.D. We please do remember him in your prayers and ask the Lord to receive him mercifully into his kingdom. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.